How much have you heard from what is in the inquiry? I know it's only published this report just a few moments ago. Hello, Julie Bailey, can you hear me?
Hello, yeah.
How much do you know about what's in the report? I know it's only published a few minutes ago.
Well, as far as we're concerned, it's the same grounds as the Healthcare Commission report. It just said about appalling standards of care. So we've heard all this before, you see. Our relatives suffered that appalling care. So really, we didn't need telling it again. What Robert Francis has agreed to, or has recommended, is another inquiry into the regulatory bodies. Now, this is what we've been asking for over a year now. We just feel that the government will agree to another inquiry, and another inquiry, and another inquiry. We've just got, I mean, circles. This is the fifth inquiry now, and how much money is he spending on another secret inquiry? Not going to give us the answers. We want to know what the regulatory bodies were doing all these years while our relatives lay dying. The regulatory bodies were giving us, it started at 3 stars. It was allowing us to become a Foundation Trust hospital. We want to know these answers.
Tell us what happened to your own mother.
My mother was in hospital for 8 weeks. It was the fourth day of the being in there. We were too frightened to leave her. From what we saw, basically, older people and vulnerable people were just left to their own devices. If they had no relatives, then they were basically left to die. I've always said all along that Mum was one of the lucky ones because she had us. We slept on a chair next to her bed. But in saying that, my mum died an awful, awful death. Dropped by a member of staff and then being denied vital medication.
So you said you're on a mobile because you're at the inquiry and the phone line is breaking up. Was she dropped, did you say?
That's right. She was dropped by a member of staff who, a care assistant, who tried to lift my mum back into bed on her own. No manual handling training. And there was no other staff available to help my mum back into bed. So she ended up dropping her. My mum died. She was due to come home 2 days later. But due to that, she died 10 days later. After that very incident, she just struggled for breath for 10 days. And it was just haphazard because you just couldn't get staff to give out medication on time. So she was prescribed. They diagnosed that she'd now got a heart condition because of the fall. And the medication just wasn't given on time. It wasn't given through. So she died, unfortunately.
I'm very sorry to hear what happened to you. You now have legal representation as a group, don't you? Will legal action follow?
That's right. We're in the first stage of challenging the Secretary of State's decision not to hold a public inquiry. We're hoping for an announcement within the next couple of weeks at the latest. We're putting our trust in the legal system. We're just hoping that they aren't going to let us down like the NHS has lost.
Worry about these stories. Oh, they may be extreme, but they, in extreme form, reflect what many people say they observe on wards in the NHS, particularly where elderly people are being cared for, which is that if you have no advocate, the standard of your care can be very poor.
Absolutely, and the Patients Association doesn't help fight, and we receive...